Hello learners, welcome back. In continuation of our earlier discussion, let us now discuss more about library staff. Well, in the previous chapter, we have discussed the staff of an information organization as a vital human resource, requirement of a staff in academic, public and special libraries, categories of library staff and their functions, staffing framework on basis of activities of the libraries, different types of staff required for a library, various stages of recruitment process and evaluation of staff performance at all the level. Well, in this section, we are going to discuss about the roles and the responsibility of a staff in a library, functions of a library, performance appraisal of library staff, staff training and development, salaries and other benefits like office management of a library staff. Well, now let us discuss about the roles and responsibility of staff in a library. Well, the top level persons, as we have discussed, usually the chief librarian should have a highest professional and academic qualification with experience, ability and competence to set achievable goal and objectives. So, he should have the ability to set targets to obtain in a particular period. So, that's very important because the top level authority is a experienced person and he should be able to complete all the required work in the libraries in an authoritative way and enforce discipline. Well, the middle level person should have the professional and academic qualification with experience to operate and as a head of the departments. So, the middle level are generally the head of the departments and they have a different work to be executed. The lower level staff should be learned more number compared to the middle level who should perform at operational level, which include routine and repetitive duties related to various work and task. Each and above level of the staff must perform at the highest performance level as per the standards to ensure the expected results. So, this is very important. Now, let us discuss the functions of a library. So, what are the basic functions? The basic functions of a library is collection building, which is called acquisition, technical processing, classification and cataloging, circulation of documents, issue and return sometimes called, stock room maintenance. So, it is very important, and maintenance of a reading room. So, sometimes when a reader go, they just put the things here and there. So, maintenance of reading room is really very important in kind of a shelving. Display of selected reference books for consultation and use, reference and information services, which is really very important to provide different categories of services of the material available in the library. And last and most important aspect of a library function is office management. So, now let us discuss all this in detail. The staff is to be distributed to those units taking into account the attitude, aptitude, interest and experience of the staff while allocating different duties and the responsibility. This is to ensure not only best performance by the staff but also their satisfaction level. So, every position in an organization and the persons who functions in the position has a role to play in achieving the target sets in tune with the goals and objective of the organizations. So, appropriate duties and responsibilities is necessary to execute the operational functions, and the authority and the responsibility generally go together. So, a library primarily is a self-oriented organization and the users are customers. We should be served just as a business how it handles their customer. So, the users are generally are important people who enter the library and use the and access the information which is available in different sections of the library. So, highest priority should be given to the user satisfaction, which is most important aspect. So, every department of the library and this subdivision must keep this as a basic principle and duty to serve the users of the library. So, this is really important, and even the housekeeping activities such as collection development, technical processing, they do have a direct contact with the users and must understand the library functions for the satisfaction of the user, this which is the primary goal of a library and will have a direct bearing on the use of the library. So, the primary goal of the library is to satisfy the users who enter the library. So the technical processing division should focus attention on the library catalog, so cataloging and reliable users guide. So this policy decision will help the serve decisions division, the library, to projecting the image of a library as an excellent service center. So staff is service unit, we all know, and having direct contact with the users has to be the ready for users temperament. So we should try to have a direct relationship with the user and try to understand the information seeking behavior, what they really want to when they enter the library. So for instance, a privileged user may sometimes seek special concessions for the liberal extension of returning of the books and the great demand for seek exemption for non-payment of overdue of the charges or the reference book to be lent. So sometimes the overdue charge is high and they need a, you know, they need to reissue the book again and again. These need to be considered as per the provision available in the library policies. So now let us discuss performance appraisal. So what is performance appraisal and how it is useful? Well, a library and the information service activities are not one-time activity but are the common continuous one. So this is not a one-time activity, it keeps going and going, and performance of the library staff at all the level has to be assessed periodically to keep the staff strength at the optimum level. So the future growth and the development is also an important aspect of the library performance. So the asset is known as a performance appraisal irrespective of the position of the staff in every organization. So performance appraisal is measurement of performance and efficiency of every employee with regard to their assigned duties and their responsibility. So they are the norms and the standards. We can say also say it's a yardstick to perform effectively at the optimum level. While it is easier to measure the quantity of a work done, measuring quality of work is more complex. So we should work on not on the quantity but the quality, how much our users are satisfied when they enter the library and how much information they have received. So in library there are many tasks that can be quantitatively measured, such as item of document classified, catalog, shelved, service, number of document issued during the day, and but how these jobs are done is a qualitative assessment. So quantitative and qualitative, these two assessments are really very important to be taken care by the staff. Now let us discuss about the performance appraisal, their objective, reason and necessity. The appraisal is not only important but also intricate for developing appropriate yardstick, as I already said, particularly in changing context of information work and services. So it is needed. Indeed, and necessary that performance strength of a staff has to be constantly and systematically enhanced to reach the highest level of efficiency and user satisfaction. This is what I am keep on repeating and repeating, that user satisfaction is sometimes really very important. So now let us discuss about the staff training and development. A library staff should be trained in a very appropriate manner. He should know his duty very well, so the development of the library should be done. The development is done on the basis of the training. So I take the training of a staff is one of the important aspect, and they keep on trained in a periodical interval of time. So the staff management is essential activity to keep performance at a maximum level in presence and in the future. The staff at all level are required to keep their professional knowledge, technology, technique constantly updated. That's what I wanted to say, that they on regular interval of time they need to grasp the new technological changes which is happening in the library field, what are the new techniques constantly coming up. So staff development implies acquisition of new knowledge in the area of relevant subject or workstation and enhance capacity to perform at a higher standard of efficiency. So education and training at all level are necessary. Without distinction of position or activity, a large information organization training development are built in activities. Now let us discuss more about the training. What is training and why it is important? As I already said, I give more focus towards the training of a library staff. What it provides? It provides skills, development, learning, coaching, knowledge, teaching and workshops. So these are some of the aspects of the training. In-house training is necessary for the new employees to enable them to be a part of new organization and blending them into the organizational environment. So blending is important aspect. We should blend, then only we will be able to perform. Existing employees very often get in service training with organizations by senior staff. This is to provide them hands-on experience and assigned job and get more exposures if they are transferred from one section to another section. So transfer from understanding the all sections of a library is important, and they should be transferred in a regular interval of time. Short duration programs and new techniques and applications on emerging technique are offered by professional associates and their institutions. So what I say that acquiring new skills and update knowledge in a fast changing field is really very important. So workshops, seminar, conferences organized at national and international level by the professional organizations are another method of staff development, and more staff should take participation in this workshop and to try to understand the new concept and the new development in the field of library and information science, so that we will be able to serve our user more better way. So this provides opportunity to the staff at all level to have interaction and to exchange the idea and experiences. Psychological traits which contribute to the successful staff performance are leadership qualities, motivational persons, experience of self-motivation. It helps in communication in the personal relationship. Well, communication and dissemination, these two things are really very important, especially for the staff, library staff who sits in the front desk and have a direct contact with the users. If you have a good skills, good communication skills and a good relationship with the users, so that you will be able to serve them in a more better way. Learners, let us discuss about another aspect of the library staff is salaries and the benefit. Salary is amount paid to the library staff in return for the work for a particular period, usually a month. Salary for the library staff varies, depends on the number of factors, type, size, location of a library and the staff position, qualification and year of experience. Well, in most of the libraries, salaries and other benefits are provided on the basis of the PERLS allowances, total salary, total remuneration, overlapping and non-overlapping. So salary structure is length of service, merits and the combination of both. So benefits are employees insurance, retirement benefits, bonus, conveyance allowance, medical benefit and monetary benefits. Now let us discuss about the office management, which is the last segment of this chapter of library staff. Every organization normally has administrative and financial units to take care of the general maintenance and physical premises. Management of the staff requirements for the purpose and supply, personal management, watch and ward, finance, accounts and other office finance function also required. So these unit functions under the supervision and control of administrative and finance officers respectively, with the administrative and finance account assistants and the section officers. So they serve under the supervision and control of the chief librarian, head of the organization, and report to them immediately. So this is all about the different functions and the staff. Now let us recap what we have learned in this chapter. So we have learned in this chapter, we focused on human resource as an important valuable for of all the resources that have the potential to transform all other resources into tangible products and the services. Staffing is an element of management that builds upon the manpower strength of any organization. The three level of staff which we have very elaborately discussed, top, middle and lower level staff. The different categories of library staffs are professional, semi-professional, non-professional and supporting staff. Staffing involves a series of steps which such as manpower planning, recruitment, selection, employment, induction, roles, responsibility, positions in different positions, performance appraisal, staff training, development. There includes continued education. Induction is necessary to introduce the new staff to their co-workers, superiors and to other staff of the library. This is it makes them feel at home in their new environment. office functions take care all the administrative financial functions of the organization. So this is what we have all learned about library staff. Thank you so much.